You're watching the beatbox battle. Switch.
My name's Hobbit. I'm a beatboxer from the UK. I've been beatboxing for about 8 years now. I started beatboxing mainly because my parents are both musicians, so I listened to a lot of music through when I was little, like even from when I was a baby, and got really inspired. Started to play the drums when I was small, carried on playing them, and then realized that you could do other things with your mouth, all right? And somebody showed me a clip of a guy called Razal, who everyone knows. And I thought, yeah, that's incredible. I need to learn how to do this. So I started imitating some of the sounds and started picking things up. And then I found out about humanbeatbox.com back when it started. And I learned how to beatbox off text tutorials of how to beatbox, and got introduced to a guy called Tite, who's an incredible beatboxer, but also he's actually a pastor. He actually... crazy. He does sermons and beatboxes at the same time, which is amazing. And he taught me a lot of stuff. I did a lot of shows. He taught me how to do workshops. He brought me, you know, he brought me along as a beatboxer. Yeah, I mean, beatboxing for me, started off beatboxing and doing a lot of open mics and paying myself to play, so trying to get my name out, pushing it on the internet. And now I do it as a living, which is just incredible. And I thank every day. I'm doing what I love as a profession, and tour around the world. I've been to all places in Europe, like France, Germany, Switzerland, Spain, Portugal. And I've been to New York. I did two tours in New York with Kid Lucky and a lot of the American guys, which was an incredible experience. And met all kinds of different beatboxers, from some beatboxers who people never heard of, and then to some of the greats like Razal and Kenny Muhammad and Killer Keller, and got to jam, meet, and party with them, and, you know, have a great time. And so I'm very thankful to have been able to travel and do this all the time. Well, for the UK scene, for the UK beatboxing, it's come on like amazingly. And when I started in like 2003, 2004, beatboxing was really quite underground still, but there was a really big community, lots of people jamming and all that kind of thing. And now you've got some incredible names who are just doing amazing things. Like, you've got people like Beardy Man, who's using all his crazy pedals and doing live shows. He's just actually released his album, which is in the shops, which is incredible. You got people like Shlomo doing lots of different things with lots of different bands. You got people like Reeps One doing visual shows with beatboxing. You got myself. I mean, I'm doing tours. I'm doing teaching the kids, or teaching everyone how to beatbox, doing shows, battling. And the battle scene in the UK has just come on amazingly. This year, 2011, the level has just gone ridiculous, and the battles are just going to be, I think it's going to be the best ones yet, definitely. From a live show point of view, I do lots of different things, from just doing a solo beatbox routine, just me and a mic, but I also use a loop station. I use the Boss RC50 to do kind of all sorts of musical things, but try not to make it take over the actual vocal and the beatboxing. You try to use it just to enhance the show rather than take over, which I still want to keep with beatboxing, because I think some beatboxers who use loop stations make the loop station the show rather than the beatbox, which I think it kind of is the same, and it withdraws beatboxing as an element and as a musical form if you're using too much electronic equipment, you know. I produce as well, and I've got my home studio, which I'm constantly making music, working on an EP at the moment, a Hobbit exclusive EP, which is coming out hopefully by summer, fingers crossed. Funny, but yeah, with me and battling, I first battled in a beatbox battle in 2006, which was kind of when the UK beatbox battling scene kind of started. And I came back last year in 2010 and got all the way through to the final and got to battle Reeps One, the already UK champion. And it's possibly one of the best battles I've experienced, I've been involved in, and I was actually in. And we had a crazy battle. And the funny story about the actual battle was literally before we got on stage, backstage, me and Reeps were actually battling back and chatting and jamming backstage. And then we're like, just before we get called on stage, we should think, oh, yeah, we should actually work on some battle routines rather than keep jamming and actually having a good time. So, I mean, it's funny when you're battling people who you know really well, and it's kind of, you got to change that. And like, I battled Yasin, who I've known since I started battling, and to battle him is such a, you have to put a different mind frame on, and it's, you know, it's quite a lot of fun. But I'm really excited to be invited to my kind of first international battle, where I get to battle some people who I've never met before today. Yo, what's going on? This is Hobbit the Human Beatbox calling to you from the UK. You're watching Beatbox Battle TV.